الله ربي والإسلام ديني ومحمدا رسول الله.
In the name of Allah, the Most Gracious and the Most Merciful. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh. On the 12th of Rabi al-Al in the year of the elephant, or 571 CE, a very significant day dawned for the Muslim community. It was the day when the last prophet, who brought forth the sacred message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, was born in Mecca, Hijaz, Arabia. The presence of this individual, who was positioned by Western scholar Michael H. Hart as the most influential person in the world, marked a turning point in the moral values of the Arab nation and humanity as a whole. The birth of the baby who would later be appointed as the great prophet was accompanied by several special qualities and astonishing events. Here are some of them. A star was born on the night when Prophet Muhammad, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, was born. Among the Jews, there were many scholars who deduced from their books that the Messenger of God would come. They were experts in drawing conclusions from the movements of stars. On the night the Prophet was born, a star shone in the sky, and the Jewish scholars understood that the last Prophet had been born. The famous poet of the Prophet, Hassan ibn Thabit, describes it as follows. I was about 8 years old. One morning, a Jewish man was running, crying out, "Hey Jews!" Jews gathered around the man, asking, "What is it? Why are you shouting?" The man was crying out, "Let me give you this news. Ahmad Star was born last night. Ahmad was born last night." The following is narrated by Ibn Sa'd regarding the issue. There was a Jewish man living in Mecca. On the morning after the night the Messenger of God was born, he went and stood in front of the people of Quraysh and asked, "Was a baby boy born last night in your tribe?" The people of Quraysh answered, "We do not know." Upon hearing this answer, he continued his speech, "Go, search and seek. The prophet of this community was born last night. He has a sign on his back." The people of Quraysh went and searched. They came back to the Jewish man and gave him the news. Abdullah had a son last night. He has a sign on his back. The Jewish man went and saw the seal of prophethood and cried out as if he had lost his mind. Prophethood is no longer with the Israelites. The people of Quraysh will be bestowed with such great fame that it will be heard everywhere from east to west. The sky was celebrating the birth of the great prophet with the brilliance of stars shining brightly. The extinguishing of the fire worshippers' flame. The religion of the Magi is one of the theological doctrines that existed long before the advent of Islam. Followers of this religion were known to highly sanctify one of the elements of nature, which is fire. For them, fire was a force that could provide protection from all kinds of dangers and bestow well-being upon humanity. Because of this belief, they considered fire as a deity to be worshipped. It is said that they had a fire that had never been extinguished for thousands of years. This fire only went out when Prophet Muhammad, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, was born. This is also mentioned in one narration by Imam al-Bayhaqi. According to Imam Azarqani, besides being narrated by Imam al-Bayhaqi, this hadith is also narrated by Ibn Asakir and Ibn Jarir at-Tabari. The throne arch of Khosrow shuddered. On the night the Prophet Muhammad, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, was born, the arch, A1, of the palace of Kisra, Khosrow's, the ancient emperor of Persia, had a terrifying dream, which caused him to tremble and his throne also tumbled and fell. 14 royal balconies collapsed. The palace of Kisra, mentioned in Imam al-Bayhaqi's narration, had 14 balconies which all collapsed when the Prophet, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, was born. This was a sign that Persian rule would only last for 14 Persian kings. The 14th, and last, Persian king ruled from the time of the Prophet's birth until the Muslims completely destroyed the whole of the Persian Empire under Umar ibn al-Khattab and Uthman ibn Affan, radhiyallahu anhuma. Born in a circumcised state, one of the obligations for every male is to undergo circumcision after reaching the age of puberty, although it is advisable to do so at an earlier age, usually around 7 years old. One of the special qualities possessed by Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was that he was already circumcised at birth. According to Imam Sulayman al-Bujarimi, in addition to Prophet Muhammad, there were 14 other prophets who were born already circumcised. These prophets include Prophet Adam, Prophet Sites, Seth, Prophet Noah, Prophet Hud, Prophet Salah, Prophet Luth, Lot, Prophet Shu'aib, Prophet Yusuf, Joseph, Prophet Musa, Moses, Prophet Sulayman, Solomon, Prophet Zechariah, Prophet Yahya, John the Baptist, Prophet Isa, Jesus, and Prophet Hanzala, who lived during the time of Tulkarnain. Prophet Hanzala is not mentioned in the Quran, but the story of the people he guided is found in the Quran. The first use of the name Muhammad. Linguistically, the word Muhammad is derived from hamdun, which means praise. This implies that the name should not have been unfamiliar to the people of Mecca at that time, as it was one of the Arabic vocabulary words. However, strangely, this name had never crossed the minds of the Arabs as a choice for naming their children until Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, used it. Imam Ibn Qutaybah emphasizes that one of the extraordinary events signaling the birth of Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was that no one had ever used the name Muhammad before him. This was preordained by Allah to preserve the sanctity of the name for Prophet Muhammad, similar to what had happened with Prophet Yahya, John the Baptist. The person who bestowed this name upon him was his grandfather, Abdul Muttalib, who wished for his grandson to be praised by all creatures. It is narrated that Abdul Muttalib received this name through a dream. In the dream, he saw a silver chain emerging from his back, with four ends stretching in different directions, one in the sky, one on the earth, one in the west, and one in the east. Then, the chain transformed into a tree, and all its leaves emitted light. All of humanity hung onto this tree. Upon interpretation, it was revealed that the dream indicated he would have descendants who would be followed by people from the west to the east and receive praise from the inhabitants of the heavens and the earth. From that moment, he was determined that when this descendant was born, he would be named Muhammad, which means the one who receives much praise. The closure access of sky's gates to devils. Before the birth of Prophet Muhammad, it is said that devils, Satan, could eavesdrop on the conversations of the angels regarding the decrees of destiny in the seventh heaven. Subsequently, devils would convey this secret information to prognosticators, enabling them to gain knowledge of the unseen. However, the information brought by devils was often deliberately distorted for his followers. When Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was born, access to the sky portal was closed, and devils could no longer eavesdrop. Regarding this matter, Abul Qasim as-Suhayli in Rad al-Anuf mentioned. It is narrated in several mutawatir, mass-transmitted, hadiths that before the sending of Prophet Isa, Jesus, devils could eavesdrop in the sky. After the sending or birth of Prophet Isa, Jesus, three layers of the skies were closed. When Prophet Muhammad was born, devils could no longer eavesdrop at all because they were pelted with stars. Stars fell down from the sky. Stars fell from the sky on the night of the Prophet's birth, signaling the end of celestial information for devils. This protected the purity of divine revelation, putting an end to widespread prognostication and leading many prognosticators to become believers. These events were not coincidental, but a divine proclamation of the last prophet, Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.